How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Snoop Dogg Saturday. And in today's video, we're going to be making stacked up flapjacks or pancakes. It's an interesting recipe though, this one. It's a lot of things in that I normally wouldn't put in. So I'm quite excited to give it a try. This is everything that we're going to need. And the first thing we're going to do is melt 6 tablespoons of butter. So we have 6 tablespoons of butter, which does look like quite a lot, to be honest. I'll just put it into the smallest bowl of 5, which is one of the kids. I'm going to just melt that in the microwave. So there we go, 30 seconds in the microwave, stirring every 10 was perfect for that. So now I'm going to whisk in the flour, baking powder, sugar and salt into a medium-sized bowl. So it's 2.5 cups of all-purpose flour, or 300 grams. Normally I'd do it in grams, but my scales are broken at the moment. 3/4 teaspoon of salt. Then 2.5 tablespoons of granulated sugar. Then finally, 2.5 tablespoon of baking powder. And then with that, just whisk it all together so it's combined, just like so. So that's really not the difficult part at all. If there is a difficult part to this at all, I don't know. Right, so we've set that medium bowl to one side, and now in a large bowl, we're gonna mix together 2 eggs, 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract, 420ml of milk, and then 5 tablespoons of the sour cream. I know that was a heaped one, but that's only because it gets stuck in there. So altogether we now have 5. And now we're going to whisk this together until it's frothy. Like that. And now we're going to add the melted butter in and whisk it again. Just till it's all together. Melted butter definitely takes that bit of froth away. Right, so now that's done, we're going to use a rubber spatula and we're going to just gently fold in the dry mix. It says using a sieve, but obviously we've already sieved it, so I'm just going to add in a bit at a time. It says don't overdo it and you still want it a bit lumpy. And not to, like I said, not to overstir. So we're going to get this done now. Okay, so it's just about all folded in. It is still a little bit lumpy, like probably more so than it should be. It's a nice thick consistency. I'm just going to keep going until like it's definitely all mixed in. Like I don't want to see any bits of flour, but it does say to leave it lumpy. Right, I consider this to be done to the way that it wants it doing. So let's see what's next. So the first thing we need to do now is we're going to add a tablespoon of butter on a large pan on a medium or medium to high heat. So we're going to get this to melt. Okay, so that is completely covered now. And then we're going to use a 1/4 cup. There we go. It's a nice thick mixture. And we'll just put it there. Okay, so these are actually going to be bigger than I expected as well. Hello there, Ivy. And then we're just going to leave it like that until it starts to bubble. And when the bubbles start to pop, we'll flip it. So, I've not flipped it yet, obviously. It's cooking nicely. They're really, really like soft, gooey, nice. Yeah, they look awesome. They look different to obviously any pancake I've made before. But they're holding like this shape now. Obviously they've not started to bubble. I'm just playing with it like so I can explain. They look really quite thick and big and they just look really good. I'm really excited for these. Obviously these aren't the healthiest thing in the world either because they're made with there's butter in them, the sugar in them, they're fried in butter. But so I want to stick to the recipe as much as possible. Okay. I'm going to give it a check. It's looking like golden brown, so we're going to give it a flip, to be honest. Oh, look at that. You see the colour? Yeah, you can see the colour. It does it justice. That looks awesome. So we're just going to do that again. Look at that. That looks fantastic. And we're going to do it exactly the same amount of time. Just thinking, if I do it a bit close to the edge, I might be able to fit two in. But yeah, that looks awesome, doesn't it? It's cooked. I know it's dangerous, but... Oh, wow. They're super soft. Okay, let's have a look. Oh, that's cooking. Awesome. I have to say that one is about done. So we don't want the butter to burn, so I'm going to keep on like just chucking it around. But like, we'll have another look. Yep. So I'm very happy with how that one is. So let's get it onto the plate. You can have a look there. So it's thick, it's soft, it's spongy, it looks amazing. So let's get a pile of them going, then we can give them a try. So if you're not too bothered about the shape, the pan I'm using can actually fit three in at one time. That's not too bad. It makes things a lot easier and quicker. So whilst they're just cooking, I've just ripped a bit off. Super soft, really spongy. I'm gonna just give it a quick try. They are a bit salty. My partner's just tried it as well and said the same. But also nice, really. The texture of them is really good. They're spongy. They're really easy to eat. They're not dry or anything. So let's get them stacked up and let's try them with syrup. Now I must say as well, just quickly, it does say to flip them carefully. And that is because it's quite a weak... I think because it's so spongy and it's so thick, it's quite weak. So if you're not careful, it will just rip in half when flipping.
Okay, so we've just stacked it with the last three, so there's four on here now. They look amazing. They really do. And we're going to go with, obviously, as Snoop suggests, some maple syrup. You just think you put some thin slices of banana in whilst cooking as well, which I think would be really good. Here we go. Bit of food porn. Oh, yeah. Right, let's get these tried. Right, so we're just going to cut into them so we can have a proper look. Oh, wow. They smell great. I really must say they smell fantastic. Look at them. They look just brilliant when I get it all. Look at that. That's great.
You probably noticed by now that I am in my pyjamas, so yeah, this is definitely my breakfast. Right, so let's give them a try. Oh, shit. They're amazing. They're so good, with maple syrup on especially. 100%, they are fantastic. Oh my God. They're the best thing I've eaten in a while. 100% make them. Just make them. Follow this exactly the way I've done it, and you'll not go wrong. As well as release for this. An absolute win of a recipe. Sorry, I'm also cooking the rest of the mix. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Obviously, if you did, leave a like and drop me a comment and let me know what you think. Obviously, subscribe if you found this good. And hopefully, I'll see you in the next one, which will be in a fortnight. I think we're going to be making cinnamon rolls. Hopefully, we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.